Hello students, myself Mr. Santosh Pawar welcomes you all in MGC Learning. In our last lecture, we had seen about your two endocrine glands, parathyroid gland and a thymus gland. Parathyroid gland, it secretes a hormone called as a PTH. It is called as a hypercalcemic hormone because it increases the level of calcium in the blood. Whereas, second gland is of a thymus gland. This thymus gland, it secretes a hormone called as a thymosin. This thymosin plays important role in the development of immune system in our body. In our today's lecture, we will see the next endocrine gland, that is pancreas. So student, our today's lecture content is pancreas. So we will see the details about the pancreas. My point number one is a position. Pancreas is located within the abdomen. So position, it is located within the abdomen. Number two, pancreas is also called as a dual gland or the heterocrine gland. It is called as a dual gland and the heterocrine gland because its some portion is of exocrine and some portion is of endocrine. Its some portion is of exocrine and some portion is of endocrine. Point number third. As our chapter name is control and coordination, we have to focus only on the endocrine part. We have to focus only on the endocrine part. So the student, endocrine part of a pancreas is called as a islets of Langerhans. I repeat, endocrine part of a pancreas is called as a islets of Langerhans. Number four, these islets of Langerhans consist of three type of cells. It has three type of cells and these cells are alpha cells, beta cells and delta cells. So students, islets of Langerhans consist of three type of cells, alpha cells, beta cells and delta cell. All these cells, they secretes a hormone. So point number five, alpha cell secretes a hormone known as a glucagon. Point number six, beta cell secretes a hormone known as insulin. And point number seven, delta cell secretes a hormone called as a somatostatin. This is about the pancreas. We will revise the part again. Endocrine part of pancreas is called as islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans has three type of cell, alpha cell, beta cell and delta cell. All these cells, they secretes hormones. Alpha cell secretes a glucagon. Beta cell secretes insulin. And delta cell secretes the somatostatin. We will see the role of each hormone in details. So we start with the first role of glucagon. The role of glucagon means importance of glucagon. Glucagon performs three functions. Function number one, it does not allow hepatocytes and adipocytes. Hepatocytes and adipocytes are the cells. So it does not allow hepatocytes and adipocytes to use glucose. As a result, glucose will not be utilized. So the concentration of glucose in the blood gets increased. I repeat, this glucagon, it does not allow hepatocyte and adipocyte to use glucose. So glucose will not be utilized. As a result, concentration of glucose in the blood gets increased. Second function. It stimulates hepatocytes for the process called as a gluconeogenolysis. Gluconeogenolysis means breakdown of a glycogen into glucose. Student, it stimulates, glucagon stimulates hepatocytes for the process called as a gluconeogenolysis. Gluconeogenolysis means breakdown of a glycogen into the glucose. So here glucose is a form. This glucose enters into the blood. As a result, concentration of glucose into the blood gets increased. Role number three, it also stimulates gluconeogenesis. It also stimulates gluconeogenesis. The meaning of gluconeogenesis means the formation of glucose from the non-carbohydrate sources. Means if the glucose is formed from the non-carbohydrate sources, that process is called as gluconeogenesis and it is stimulated by the glucagon. In this process also glucose is formed. This glucose is also enters into the blood. As a result, the concentration of a glucose in the blood gets increased. If you see the role of a glucagon, glucagon increases the level of a sugar or a glucose into the blood. It increases the level of a glucose into the blood. So glucagon is called as a hyperglycemic hormone. Glucagon is called as a hyperglycemic hormone. Let's see the role of insulin. Role of insulin. As I said, insulin is secreted by the beta cells of islets of Langerhans. It performs the following function. It stimulates, it allows hepatocytes and adipocytes to use glucose. It stimulates hepatocytes and adipocytes to use glucose. So glucose gets utilized. As a result, the concentration of glucose into the blood gets decreased. It allows or it stimulates the hepatocytes and the adipocyte for the utilization of a glucose. So glucose gets utilized. As a result, the concentration of a glucose into the blood gets a decrease. So student, here insulin decreases the level of a glucose into the blood. So it is called as a hypoglycemic hormone. It is called as a hypoglycemic hormone. So insulin is a hypoglycemic hormone. Glucagon is a hyperglycemic hormone. Let's see the role of a somatostatin. Somatostatin is secreted by the delta cells of islets of Langerhans. Its role is what? It controls the secretion of a glucagon and the insulin hormone. It controls or it inhibits the secretion of a glucagon and the insulin hormone. This is the role of a somatostatin. So students, here we have seen the role of a glucagon, role of a insulin, and the role of a somatostatin. Our next part is maintenance of glucose level, means how glucose level is maintained into the blood. Point one, if there is an excess of glucose in the blood, if there is an excess of glucose in the blood, then the one hormone which is called as insulin, it is secreted out. This insulin, which is an hypoglycemic hormone, it allows hepatocytes and adipocyte to utilize the glucose. Insulin hormone, it allows hepatocyte and adipocyte to use glucose. As a result, glucose gets utilized. Because of this, concentration of glucose into the blood gets decreased. So insulin hormone, it decreases the level of glucose into the blood. So it is called as a hypoglycemic hormone. Number two, if there is less glucose in the blood, the another hormone is secreted out, which is called as a glucagon. This glucagon, it does not allow hepatocyte and adipocyte to use glucose. So glucose will not be utilized. As a result, concentration of a glucose into the blood gets increased. Further, it stimulates the hepatocyte for the gluconeogenolysis. It stimulates the hepatocytes for the gluconeogenolysis, that is breakdown of glycogen into the glucose. As a result, the concentration of glucose into the blood gets increased. This glucagon hormone, it also stimulates gluconeogenesis, that is formation of glucose from the non-carbohydrate sources. This results in the increase in the level of glucose into the blood. So if there is a less glucose in the blood, glucagon plays important role. This is called as a maintenance of a glucose level in the blood. Let's see the disorders of pancreas. The disorder of pancreas is of only one type, which is called as a diabetes mellitus. This diabetes mellitus is caused because of a deficiency of insulin hormone. Deficiency of insulin hormones means if there is a malfunctioning of beta cells of islets of Langerhans, then the insulin is secreted in a very less amount, or sometimes it may not be secreted. If it is secreted in a very less amount, condition is called as a deficiency of insulin. This deficiency of insulin causes the disorder called as a diabetes mellitus. Into this diabetes mellitus, glucose levels are high. Further, this excess amount of glucose is excreted out from the urine. This excess amount of glucose is excreted out from the urine. So this is about your disorders of a pancreas. So student, in our today's lecture, we have seen about your pancreas and its hormones. Thank you so much.